Oh, Sunday night. Sunday night's a good night to put things online because, well, there's just not a lot of people here. And you really have to go back to the original idea of what the internet was supposed to be. And that was the Information Superhighway. Now, a lot of people think you are talking some crazy conspiracy. You say, well, if there's more people on that highway, at some times rather than other times, then the busy times are going to be congested, right? Like a road. There is a limited quantity there. And if you fill up those quantities, you're not going to move very fast. And that's what happens on the internet. Now, we have an election on November 5th, and then we go into what is traditionally known as the Christmas season, the holiday season. And with computers, that shopping is pretty crazy because you have a lot of people just have to do really slow browsing, and they're doing it when they're doing everything else. They're often doing it at work. And I kind of tell people that from the beginning of Thanksgiving week till the beginning of Christmas week, do something else. It's just going to make your life easier. This is why you keep hobbies. We have our trains. We do art. We make more jewelry. We play with our records. That's the time for something else. And that's my warning. It's an Information Superhighway. Right before Thanksgiving, rush hour starts. This year, we also have a lot of people still out in the South. A lot of cables messed up, a lot of messiness. So things are messier now than they should be. We also have a really odd election. So, why don't we just all relax and remember that there was a world before the internet? It's hard to remember. But remember, the more time you spend off the internet, the more you're going to have time to learn things and experience things that will make you more interesting when you get back on the internet. And that'll probably be around the Super Bowl. Yeah. We don't know what's going to happen after the election. Ooh, yeah. It's, yeah, we're going into a lot of unknown territory here. I think it was also later in January, or might be early January, that we're going to have the dock workers strike part two. Remember, they did not figure that thing out. I freaked them out. I'm always honest on and forthright when I go on the radio. And the other hosts, I'm not a host, but I'm a regular caller and I'm pretty well known in the Bay Area. They did 20 minutes of things that can make you feel happy before I got on to the air, and I kind of took that as a hint, and everyone else, I think, took it as a warning, and they decided to push the whole thing off until after Christmas. When it's colder. Yeah. Do we need automation? At ports, or if it's in the ports, it has to be everywhere. Or if it's not in the ports, it's not going to be everywhere. With the Starbase things, I'm trying to kind of convince them that you're probably going to do better if you can standardize. I mean, if you could take a container off of a train and off of a ship and put it straight onto the Starship and ship it to Mars, I mean, it's probably going to be easier than going through the process of having to unlock it, go through the company that is shipping it. So, that'd be that. No Starbase news. It's all quiet there. They got their booster. And, having nice, sleek black little cars coming in at the middle of the night. Or actually, leaving at the middle of the night. Yeah. How the heck they get away with keeping the camera out in the front of the place the entire time? And why people watch it is even weirder. And why they come out of Britain and are either from Los Australia, Britain, or Canada. Sounds rather six-ish to me. They also really didn't like it when I mentioned Chitty Chitty Bang Bang.